All right.
Hey, welcome back. Halloween edition.
Halloween. Frank's working on our jack-o'-lanterns.
We're just carving up this place.
Carving up a storm. Yep, we sure are. Frank, how's it going?
Okay, guys. I want to show you what I got here so far. And the first trick to this thing is to put your stencil on, use an awl or ice pick, make your little dots. So I went around and made my little dots. So I'm ready to take this off now. And it's going to be hard to see on camera, but I've got a little, all my little dots now are in the shape, the same shape as my stencil. Yeah, I can see some of them there now. There's some over here. There you go. So now the trick, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut those out with a sharp knife or use my saw. And it's going to start to look like something. So check back with me.
Sort of connect the dots, right?
Pardon me?
Connect the dots?
Yeah, it's just a matter of connecting the dots.
Awesome.
So, okay, check back.
All right, so it's all jack-o'-lanterns all the time. I used to do this lesson when I taught graphic design, and it's always a great lesson because the kids really enjoy it. And it's a really good way to show them how to use all of these different drawing tools in vector-based graphic programs like Fireworks, Adobe Fireworks, which is what I'll use today.
But you could also teach middle school, so this
did.
Is easy
this
enough
is,
for
absolutely.
Middle school.
Sixth graders used to love this thing. Sixth, seventh, eighth grade, I loved it. It's a lot
almost
of fun.
Easy enough for a fifth grader.
Almost easy enough for you. So, and you could do the same kind of techniques in other vector-based applications like this. So, you see my little jack-o'-lantern that's all animated?
Yeah.
And I'm going to stop the animation, and we're going to rip through a new document that will let us do this. Now, I'm actually going to turn my canvas white to begin with, make it a little easier to work with. And I'm going to use, on the left-hand side of the window, all of my tools. All right? All of my tools are on the left-hand side of the window. And the bottom of the window is the Properties Inspector. I'll be using that. Mm-hmm. On the right side of the window, I have my panels, and I'll be using those. So this is a good exercise to get yourself into using all the tool set in Fireworks. So, beginning on the left, we're going to start our pumpkin by just using this tool called the ellipse tool.
Okay.
And we're going to draw out a circle, just kind of flattened out that circle. I'm not really going to worry about colors right now, because the first thing I want to do is I want to punch, just like what Frank is doing, I want to cut holes in my pumpkin.
Okay.
So I'll do that by drawing some basic shapes. I'm going to use the polygon tool, and with the polygon tool, I'm going to set the kind of tool that it is here. I'm going to actually make that into a little kind of a star shape here. This is actually a star. Let me scale that down just a little bit using the scale tool and the distort tool.
Oh, nice.
This is going to be my eye. Now, the nice thing about graphic design like this is you don't have to do things over and over again. You can just do one and then duplicate it. So let me come in here nice and tight. And I'm going to draw another little circle for the iris. I'm going to draw it down underneath it. And then I'll take my pointer tool and drag it up here. And I'm going to select them both, just what we call marquee. So I'll draw a little box around it. And then I'm going to go to Modify, Combine Paths, and Punch. I'm going to do this a lot. So basically, I put one shape on top of the other and punch the top shape through the bottom shape.
That's
now,
neat.
I'm going to duplicate these, okay? So Command-C, Command-V gives me two duplicates. There's my eyes, all right? So I've got the two eyes I need. And let me change my magnification down. So I'll put my first eye in place. Good idea here is to go ahead and change the color of these things so I can see where they're going. It doesn't matter what color
the
they are.
The blue lines help, too.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what color. So I'm going to do the same thing. There's my eye. There's my pumpkin. Modify, Combine Paths, and Punch.
Punch. Poof.
Okay, there's my
cut
eye.
It out.
And this one needs to be flipped, so Modify. I'm going to alter the path this time. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm going to transform it. That's what I'm going to do. And flip horizontal. So now I've got my other eye, and again, if I change the color, it makes it easier for me to position it. And there's that one. And again,
punch
modify,
it.
Combine paths, and punch. All right?
Nice.
So I've got the beginnings of my jack-o'-lantern. Now I need a mouth. I'm going to do a circle again down here at the bottom. And this time I'll take the knife tool, and holding down the shift key, I'll drag a line right across and cut that circle into two. Take that one, delete it. Oops, wrong keyboard. Delete it. And now I will put some teeth in. And again, I'm just going to draw a little shape, change the color so I can see it real well. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this as a master. I'll use a little trick. I'm going to hold down the Alt key so I get a duplicate. So I hold down my Alt key, select them. Guess what I'm going to do?
Punch.
Combine pass and punch it again. And I'll just do the same thing again until I get my mouth the way I want it. So you see how I'm kind of building it off of the actual object itself? And let me just alt-drag that one more time. Modify, combine, pass, and punch. All right, nice. Okay, we're going. So now I'm going to take my sub-selection tool, and I'm going to use that to modify these actual points. I can take these points, and I can drag them up. I can distort the shape of my object by moving the endpoints, and I can make it all sorts of unusual stuff.
When you get that all done.
When I get that done.
You're going to go up, Ed.
I'm going to stick it up on the pumpkin, change the color again so I can spot it. All right. And guess what I'm going to do?
Punch.
Modify, combine pass, and punch. Okay?
That is nice.
So there's the beginning of my pumpkin. And, of course, it needs to be orange now. So let me select her and choose a nice orange color. Okay?
That's nice. Orange and blue.
Orange and blue. Yeah, I've heard of those colors. All right, now, so how do I make this animated? How do I make this animated? I make this animated by making multiple copies, like a flip book. Right?
Okay.
So I have my first master copy, and I'm going to look over my layers panel over on the right-hand side because I want to lock this panel here. I want to lock this layer, and I'm going to add a new layer, and I'm just going to draw a shape that basically is the glow that happens behind the pumpkin. All right? So right now it's above the pumpkin. I need to put it behind the pumpkin. So I go to Arrange, send to back. And still it's orange. I don't want it to be orange. I'm going to use a gradient fill. And I'm going to use this fancy starburst one here. Now you can see the colors, but it's not quite right because the colors are wrong. So let me change my colors here. And we'll make this one red-ish. Okay?
Okay.
All right. And now I've got these glow that's behind the pumpkin.
That is nice.
And what I'll do is in Fireworks, I'll go to States here, and I'm going to duplicate this. I'm just going to drag this down and, close my program accidentally. All right, so I'm just going to duplicate this state. So every time I duplicate, I've got an option to change my glow. So let me go here and just give it, we'll just do four states because of lack of time. I'll click OK. Now, each of the states, what I want to do is I want to come in and I want to make changes to this glow. And since I used a gradient, I can use these little handles here.
Oh, nice.
And I can move those in like that. And I just go to each one individually and I make my changes the way I want them to be. So I go to every state, like a different page in a flipbook. And now I have an animated jack-o'-lantern.
Oh, wow, look at that.
Just
like that.
All right, so less than 10 minutes. And uses all the tool sets that you would use for doing illustrations, and yet it's something really fun that kids as young as, 10 or 11 can handle this.
Okay, that's great. We're going to be right back in a little bit. I'm going to show you a Halloween game and some places to get some things, and Lee Colbert's got some more cool stuff.
I can't wait.
Okay.
Let's go.